examples on the source shifting. One example on source shifting and few examples on source transformation. Okay, so we'll continue today in this session with the examples on source shifting and source transformation. This include both. Okay, so as per the example, already I have written the example so as to save the time. Okay, so using source transformation and source shifting, find the voltage across 2 ohm resistor in the circuit shown. Okay, so this is a 2 ohm resistor. I have to find the voltage across this 2 ohm resistor. Okay, voltage across this 2 ohm resistor I need to find using source shifting and source transformation. Okay, when I observe this circuit at first, okay, direct source transformation is not possible because there is no resistor in series with 5 volt and there is no resistor in parallel to 2 amps source directly. There is no direct resistor which is in series with 5 volts. There is no direct resistor which is in parallel to 2 ampere source. So therefore, source transformation alone will not help us to get the required solution. So first I need to do the source shifting. Now in the previous example of source shifting, we have seen that there was only one voltage source and we shifted that voltage source beyond the node and then we calculated to get the solution. But now in this example, there is a current source and there is a voltage source. So I need to do the shifting of current source and voltage source wherever necessary and if necessary. Okay, so you don't think that source shifting has to be done compulsorily all the time. Even when it is mentioned, sometimes source shifting may not be necessary. Okay, in some cases source shifting may not be necessary. So first we need to observe whether we can go ahead with the solution without source shifting. If not, then you do take source shifting. If yes, then just by simple transformation we can get to the solution. By observing the example circuit given here, there is no possibility of source transformation as in the given circuit without the shifting. So here I have to go for source shifting of both voltage source as well as current source. Okay, so first we will take one by one. And one thing what we should observe here is I need to find the voltage across this 2 ohm resistor. Therefore, this branch containing 2 ohm resistor should be retained till the end of the analysis. I cannot make this branch of 2 ohm resistor consumed in any of the step. So here initially let me name the nodes. Let's say node A, node B and node C. It is for our reference. Okay, so I need to find the voltage across this 2 ohm resistor. So first what we will do is, first we will shift let us first shift five volt source. Now where should I shift 5 volt source? There is a possibility of shifting this 5 volt source beyond the node C, and also you can name this node D, beyond the node D also. Okay, there is a possibility of shifting this 5 volt source beyond node C and beyond node D. Now if I will shift this 5 volt source beyond node D, it will come to branch of 2 ohm and also it will come in the branch between A and D, and we will get a branch in such a way that I will be having an independent voltage source and independent current sources in series. Okay, independent voltage source and independent current source I will get in series. So now that is one thing. Second thing is that now once I take this 5 volt source into this 2 ohm branch, then I cannot reduce that branch further because I need this 2 ohm till the end of analysis. So it is convenient for me if I shift this 5 volt source beyond the node sink. So let us first shift 5 volt source beyond node sink. Now observe the polarities of these resistors. This 4 ohm is connected to node C. Now node C is at positive polarity with respect to this 5 volt connection. Now the right terminal of 4 ohm is positive. The right terminal of 3 ohm is positive. Now I should be shifting this 5 volt source in such a way that the right terminals of 3 ohm and 4 ohm should be positive, under positive potential point. Okay. So let us first shift 5 volt source beyond node C. We'll do that. This is 2 ohm source as it is. I have not touched it yet. This is node A. This is node B. This is node D. And this 5 volt source is shifted into beyond node C, that it will come in series with 4 ohm and 3 ohm. So this is 4 volt source. Now the right terminal of 3 ohms should be positive. The right terminal of 4 ohm should be positive. So to get that, the left terminal of voltage source should be positive in both the branches. Okay. And the original branch containing the voltage source should be replaced by a short circuit. Now this is the circuit after the source shifting is done. Okay, but still this circuit will not yield any solution directly. Yeah, now observe. There is a current source of 2 amperes which can also be shifted across the branches connected to that source. Now see here, there is a branch, this is 2 ohms, and this is 5 ohms. Okay, 5 ohm resistor and 2 ohm resistor are connected across 2 amperes. So therefore I should shift this 2 amperes across 5 ohm and across 2 ohm in such a way that the current should enter node A, the current should leave node D, and the current at node B of this 2 ampere source should be zero. Okay. So next part what we do is shift. Two ampere source. Across 5 ohm and 2 ohm resistors. Yeah, across 5 ohm and 2 ohm resistors. Okay. Now I am shifting across 5 ohm and 2 ohm because 5 ohm branch and 2 ohm branch are connected to the nodes where this current source is connected. That is the reason. Okay. I will keep the other things as it is. this is node C. This is 4 ohms, 3 ohm, plus minus 5 volt, 5 volt. This is 5 ohm and this is 2 ohm. So now I will be shifting this 2 ampere source across 5 ohm and 2 ohm such that the current 2 amperes will enter node A and current 2 amperes will leave node D. So this is node A, B, C and D. The current is entering node A, 2 amperes. And current is leaving node D, it is 2 amperes. And at node B, the moment 2 ampere current enters, it will exit. So here if you see the original circuit, there is no connection of 2 ampere source to the node B. It means that no 2 ampere current, the current of this source has got no effect at node B. Similarly, even when the sources are connected at node B, the moment 2 ampere current enters here, it will exit. So in the other part of the circuit, this 2 ampere current will not flow through node B. That is important. It may be flowing through node A, it may be flowing through node D, but through node B, this current has got no effect in the circuit. So therefore, the remaining part of the circuit will remain unchanged. Now you can observe that this 2 ampere and 5 ohm are in parallel. It is a practical current source which can be transformed into a practical voltage source. Here 2 ampere and 2 ohms are also in parallel. It is also a practical current source, but I don't transform this as I need this 2 ampere 2 ohm resistor intact unchanged till the end of the solution, because I want to find the voltage across this 2 ohms, and hence I need to keep this 2 ohm resistor same or unchanged till the end of till the last step we reach in this analysis. So what I do next is transform two ampere 5 ohm current source into voltage source. Into voltage source. Now keeping the other things intact. So this is 2 ohm. Across this I have a current source of 2 amperes. This is 3 ohms. This is 4 ohms. 5 volts. 5 volts. Okay. So now this 2 ampere 5 ohm resistor can be transformed into a voltage source. It can be transformed into a voltage source where the resistor remains 5 ohms. This resistor 5 ohms remains same, and the voltage source, let this be V1. Okay, see the direction of 2 ampere source. It is from node B to node A. Let this be A, B, this is C, and this is D. Okay. So now the current 2 ampere is flowing from node B to node A. Therefore, positive terminal is towards node A of this source, negative terminal is towards node B of this source. Okay. So this is the transformation where V1 is equals to the product of current and resistor, 2 ampere multiplied by 5 ohms, that is 10 volts. Okay, that is 10 volts. Okay, so this is 10 volts. Now you can observe here that two voltage sources are in series, 10 volt 5 ohms and 5 volt 3 ohms. Okay, so these two voltage sources are in series. Hence, I can take the effective value. Okay, I can take the effective value. So here I will write it. Here 10 volt 5 ohm and 5 volt 3 ohm sources are in series. And effective value can be taken. Okay, so I will get a new circuit where now this 5 ohm and 10 volts, 3 ohm and 5 volts are in series. So this node becomes B. Node A will get consumed in the effective value calculation. And here, this is 2 ohms. Okay. This is node C, 5 volt. This is 4 ohms. Sorry. And across these 2 ohms, I have a current source of 2 amperes. Okay. Now this resistor is the sum of effective value. It is the effective value of two internal resistances, 5 ohm and 3 ohm. So this is 8 ohms. And this voltage source is the effective value of 10 volts and 5 volts. So only observe here, 10 volt and 5 volt, both are opposing each other. It is in this direction, it is also in this direction. It appears that both are in the same direction towards left, but that is not the case. Okay. These two are in series. Okay, so 10 volt is opposing this 5 volt. 10 volt is opposing this 5 volt. So therefore, the effective value is 10 minus 5 volts. And the polarity of this is this. Okay, it is towards right. Why? Because the polarity of 10 volt should be taken into account, as 10 volt is larger than 5 volt. If you are getting confused, I will redraw this circuit once again. Okay. Because it is appearing that both 10 volt and 5 volt, they are in the same direction, if there is a confusion. Okay, so this I will redraw it here. Just a moment. Okay. Now I will redraw this. Here this is node B. Okay. C. This is 2 ohm. This is 4 ohm and 5 volts. Okay. Now, if you see this connection from B to A, so this is 5 volt, 3 ohm, this is 5 ohm and 10 volts. Now I think it is more clear than this direct circuit. Now 10 volt is towards right and 5 volt is towards left. Now both 10 volt and 5 volt are opposing each other. Therefore, the effective value of these two voltages will be 10 minus 5, that is 5 volts. And the polarity will be of the higher source values voltage, that is 10 volts. So right side will be positive, left side will be negative. So this circuit is from this circuit. Now I think it is more clear than directly taking this part. Okay. So now you can observe with this solution that there are two voltage sources in parallel. Please remember one thing, that these 2 ohms cannot be touched till the last step. So I have to keep it intact. So I need not to change it. Okay. And one more thing is, this node D, this is node D, and because of short circuit between node D and node C, there is no change between node D and node C. Node D is directly connected to node C. So this circuit I will redraw it. Okay. Two ohm. In parallel with 2 amps. So this is node D, this was C, okay? So it is connected to a common connection. So this is 4 ohms, 5 volts, and this is 8 ohms and 5 volts. So now there are two voltage sources in parallel. I cannot realize or minimize two voltage sources directly in parallel. Those have to be connected to, transformed to the current sources. Okay. You can write a comment. Two voltage sources five volt, 4 ohm, and 5 volt, 8 ohm. Are in parallel. And can be transformed to current sources. Okay, so I will transform these two current voltage sources into current sources. Keeping this 2 ohm as it is. Okay. So this is 4 ohms and this is 8 ohms. Now the direction of 5 volt is upward. So this will be upward. Let this be I1, and the direction of 5 volt is downward, and let this be I2. So I1 is equals to, it is 5 by 4. It is 1.25 amps, and I2 is equals to, it is 5 by 8. It is 0.625 amps. Okay. Put this one here. 0.625 amps. Okay. Now, 1.25, 1.625. Okay. So now observe, there are three current sources here: 2 amps, 1.25 amps, and 0.625 amps. I can take the effective value of all these three, and I have three resistances in parallel: 2 ohm, 4 ohm, and 8 ohm. But I need voltage across 2 ohm, I will keep it as it is. Okay, and I take effective value of only 4 ohm and 8 ohm. So, taking the effective values or taking the resultant, anything can look. Taking effective values, okay. I will keep 2 ohm as it is. I won't do any operation on 2 ohms. Okay. The other resistor, let me call it as R. It is 2 ohms, it is R. And I have the current. Now observe, there are two currents of 2 ohms and 1.25 ohm, 2 amps and 1.25 amps upward, and the downward current 0.625 is lesser than both the sum together. Okay, so let me call this as I. So I is equals to, it is 2 amps plus 1.25 amps minus 0.625 amps. So this comes out to be 3.25 minus 0.625, it is around 2.4 amps.2.625 amps. Okay, this comes out to be 2.625 amps. Okay. So the direction of this current is upward, obviously, because 2 amps and 1.25 amps combinedly are larger than 0.625 amps. Therefore, the direction of these two will be the direction of current. So 2.625. Now what I want is the voltage across 2 ohms. Now I can find out the current I 2 ohms and multiply it with 2 ohms, I will get the voltage across 2 ohms. So therefore, voltage across 2 ohm is V2 ohms is equals to I 2 ohms into 2. But what is I 2 ohms? It is the branch current. Apply branch current formula. And what is R? Sorry, we forgot to calculate R. Okay, so R is equals to 2 ohm is kept as it is. I have to take the effective value of 4 ohm and 8 ohm. That is 4 parallel 8 equals to 4 into 8 divided by 4 plus 8. So 32 divided by 12.
2.6.
Yes, 2.6 ohms. Okay. So I 2 ohms is equals to, it is main current I, that is 2.625 into the opposite branch resistance, that is 2.6 ohms. Opposite branch resistance is 2.6 divided by total resistance, 2.6 plus 2. Yeah. I 2 ohms is value. Can anybody tell? Yes. No. How come?
1.48
1.483 amperes. Okay, so V2 ohms is equals to 1.483 into 2 ohms. It will come around 2.98 or 2.99. Is it 2.96 volts? So the voltage across 2 ohm is 2.96 volts. So we should be observing what is been asked to find, and that element where it is existing, okay, and whether that can be consumed in any transformation or not. If it is getting consumed in any transformation or shifting, we should not touch that. Okay? So this is how we have to find the solution for the given example. Any doubts in this? Any doubts in this example solution?
No, sir.
Then we'll move to next example. This is one more example. Reduce the following network into a single practical voltage source using source shifting and source transformation. Okay, so this is the network given. This is one of the question paper example. Okay, previous year question paper example. I have to find, I have to reduce the network to obtain single practical voltage source between A and B. Okay, using source shifting and source transformation. Okay. We'll solve it. Solution. At first, let me name the nodes. It will be easy for us to recognize the things. This is terminal A. Let me note this as U, V, W, and X. Now because A and V are already there, I just want to take different names. That is the reason. Okay. Now, this is a 45 ampere current source, which has to be shifted across 2 ohm and 5 ohm strictly. Okay, why strictly only across 2 ohm and 5 ohm? Because this 2 ohm and 5 ohm are connected to a common node at terminal A. Okay, but when you observe, if I have to shift this 45 amp source across 8 ohm and 10 ohm, there is no common node connected between 8 ohm and 10 ohm. Between the connection of 8 ohm and 10 ohm at the other ends, there is another voltage source or other circuit element present. So I cannot shift this 45 ampere current source across 8 ohm or 10 ohm. Because if I have to shift across 8 ohm or 10 ohm, then 45 amperes has to be shifted to connected across 8 ohm V. 45 amperes has to be connected across 10 ohms. Okay? At X. But what about this VX source? These two, V is at a different potential, X is at a different potential. So there is a potential difference between V and X. Therefore, there is some sort of current present. Okay. But if I do this 45 ampere shifting across 8 ohm and 10 ohm, it will be entirely a different circuit than what is what we are having. Okay. So therefore, one thing we should observe is that whenever we are shifting the sources, whether the source shifting is feasible across all the elements or not, the current source has to be shifted across the elements strictly, okay, in such a way that the effect of current has to be present only at the terminal nodes of it, that is at node U and node W here. But if I connect 45 amperes current source across 8 ohms, it has to be connected across 8 ohm and connected to V here. But if I take the direction of 45 amperes towards U, it appears that 45 amperes is coming out of node V. But when in the original circuit, node V is nowhere connected to 45 amperes of current source. And the same problem we observe in node X also. If I take this 45 amperes across 10 ohms, okay, it appears that at W the current has to leave, but at X the current has to enter. But in the original circuit, X is not getting any 45 amperes of current to it. So therefore, that connection is not valid. So the valid connection to connect this voltage current source is only across 2 ohm and five. Okay, so here this is one case. Second case, now I can shift this 30 volt voltage source beyond node V or beyond node X. Both will give the same result. Okay, there is no harm. There is no harm absolutely. Whether I shift it beyond node X or beyond node V, there is no harm. Okay, there is no compulsion like that. Nothing. So therefore, I can consider shifting on any side. Okay, so first I will do it simultaneously to save the time, because we already know. I hope that you have understood the source shifting technique. Okay, shift 45 ampere current source across 2 ohm and 5 ohm and shift 30 volt voltage source, okay, beyond node V. I will take node V as a homework example. You shift it beyond node X and verify whether we get the same result. It is your homework. Okay, beyond node V. I will give some different appearance to V here. Beyond node V. Okay, we'll do it simultaneously. Beyond node V, 30 volts will come in series with 8 ohm and in series with 3 ohms. This is node V, this is node U, this is node W, this is X. This is terminal B. Okay. Now, this is a 2 ohm, 8 ohm, 3 ohm, 6 ohm, 10 ohm, and 5 ohms. So, a current source at W, the current has to leave. So 45 amps. At U, the current has to enter. Okay. So right terminal of 8 ohm is at positive potential, and the left terminal of 3 ohm is at positive potential. So right terminal of 8 ohm, to keep it positive, my voltage source should have one plus sign on the left. This is 30 volts. And to keep the left terminal of 3 ohm positive, my voltage source should be having positive terminal on right. So this is 30 volt. So this is what we get after source shifting. And observe, the original branch between U and W should be kept open circuited because it is current source, but the original branch between V and X should be kept short circuited. Okay, should be kept short circuited. So this is the new circuit we obtained. Now, simplifying this, I have this current source in parallel with 2 ohms, this 45 amps in parallel with 5 ohms. I will convert 45 amps 2 ohms and 45 amps 5 ohms in voltage source. Okay, so here I will take transform. Forty-five amp two ohm and forty-five amp five ohm voltage source into current source. Current sources into voltage source. Okay, so redrawing the circuit, terminal A, my 2 ohm will remain as it is. I will get a voltage source. This is 8 ohms. In series to that, I have 30 volts. Okay. Here it is 5 ohms. In series to that, I will get a voltage source. Here I have 10 ohms. Yeah, now observe node V and node X are directly connected through a short circuit. They form the same node. Okay. So I will take it as same node. Now to this node V, I will take it as node V only. To this node V, I have a voltage source. Of 30 volts. This is terminal B, and from this node X, from this point X, I have a, now X is not a node, okay, this V and X have merged here. Okay. There is a, sorry, a resistance of 6 ohm. Okay. A resistance of 6 ohm. Now, what about these voltage sources V1 and V2? Let me call it as V1 and V2. The direction of 45 amps is towards terminal U, node U, and this is W. Therefore, V1 will be having positive polarity towards U and negative towards A. V2 will be having positive polarity towards A and negative towards W. So I will directly write the value here. I will not calculate separately. Is it okay? Because we know that 45 amps and 2 ohms, it is 90 volts. And what about V2? 45 amps and 5 ohms. So So this comes out to be 235 volts. Now observe, 90 volt and 30 volt are in series, 2 ohm and 8 ohm are in series, 5 ohm and 10 ohm are in series, but there is no any other voltage source in series with 235 volts. So I can take the effective value here.
Sir, it's 225.
220, oh sorry. 180 plus 45, na? 225. Sorry. In a hurry, I make some mistakes. Okay. Now, taking effective value of 90 volt and 30 volt. Taking effective value of 90 volt 2 ohm and 30 volt and 8 ohms. Okay. So what I get here is terminal A. Okay, in a more proper way, I have drawn that symbol. This is as it is, 30 volts. And here, it is 2 ohm plus 8 ohm, 10 ohms. 5 ohm plus 10 ohms, it is 15 ohms. Voltage value will be same, plus minus 225 volts. Here it is 90 volts plus 30 volts. So it is 90 volt is towards right, 30 volts is towards left. So 90 volt and 30 volts are opposing each other. Hence, there will be difference of two voltages to get the effective value. It will be 60 volts. And the polarity will be of larger value. It is 90 volts. So minus and plus. Okay, now this is the circuit. Now I think it is only the matter of source transformation. Is it? Two voltage sources are in parallel. I have to convert them into current sources. There is a voltage source and a resistance in parallel. Therefore, I have to consider this into, can transform this into again a current source. Then take the effective value of 6 ohm and 3 ohm resistance. Convert that back to voltage source, because practically, ultimately what I want is the practical voltage source. What I want is practical voltage source. Okay. Now do this, how are getting this result? 34 volts and 8 ohms. So this is the solution. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So with this example solution, we'll end the today's session, and in next class we will look into the star delta transformation of resistance, which is another circuit reduction technique of passive elements.